Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/APOD. And today's picture for November the 3rd of 2019, well, it is titled Daphnis and the Rings of Saturn. So what do we see here? Well, this is a very close-up view of just a small portion of Saturn's rings. And we can see all of the structures located within them. So we see the rings and they look very beautiful and majestic. But when we look into the details, there is a lot more there to see. And we can see various lines and things going through the rings. And these are concentrations of particles. Some of the brighter areas, you might have more particles that are reflecting light. And some of the darker areas, you'll have less particles. Now, within the darkest area in the middle here, there appear to be no particles at all. And that is one of the smaller gaps of Saturn's rings. The Cassini division is a much larger one, well known, but this one occurs as well, and this is known as the Keeler gap. So it is a gap between the rings where there is a very lower, much lower concentration of ring particles. Now, within this is actually a moon, and that is the moon known as Daphnis, a very small moon, only about 8 kilometers, maybe about 5 miles across. So not very big at all, and a very low density, very icy object. And in fact, is an accumulation of, may have an accumulation of ring particles on its surface. So that may be where some of its material comes from. And we can see a little bit of that in the structure of the moon. Now, we also see the very interesting portion of this is you can see some of the what it's done to the inner portion of this ring, how it's modified it with its gravity. Now, the ring particles do not rotate as a solid body, and that means that the ones that are closer to Saturn will move around faster, and then the ones at Daphnis region will move at another speed, a little slower, and then further out will move even slower. So Daphnis is slowly overtaking the inner ring particles and slowly slowly passing the outer ring particles. So the inner ring particles are passing Daphnis, the outer ring particles, Daphnis is passing. And that can cause some structures by its gravity. Even though it's very small, we can see some of the rippled effect that can occur as these particles pass one another. So it gives us some very interesting structures that we have been studying for a while. And these images taken by the Cassini spacecraft, which orbited Saturn for over a decade before plunging into the atmosphere of Saturn a couple of years ago, are still things that we are studying today. So the data that have been gathered are things that still are very useful and we're still getting a lot out of today to really understand how the rings work and the interaction between Saturn's many moons and its rings. A lot of the structures that we see, not just this rippling effect, but even the concentration of particles in various areas, are all believed to be caused by the moons of Saturn. Not just this moon, but it's dozens of other moons that exist well within the rings and well outside the rings as well. So there seems to be a great interaction between the ring particles and the moons, giving the ring particles the structures that we see. So that was our picture of the day for November the 3rd of 2019. It was titled Daphnis and the Rings of Saturn. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Turmoil in a Stellar Lagoon. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.